finally tonight. It wouldn't be a show about Marvel and Stan Lee if the man himself didn't get a word in edgewise. What you're about to see was discovered in the archives of ABC News. It's never before seen footage of Stan reading a letter to his younger self. So, as we say goodnight, I very willingly turn the final moments of our broadcast over to the man himself, Stan Lee.
Dear Stan, I still remember how you always wanted to be a writer. In your last year at DeWitt Clinton High School, you practiced signing your name, Stanley Martin Lieber, over and over again, making it look as bold and impressive as any of those at the bottom of the Declaration of Independence. You were so certain the day would come when you'd write that great American novel and people would ask for your autograph, and you wanted to be prepared. Well, how could you have imagined the ironic development in later years? Today, people do occasionally request your autograph, but not for the great American novel, which you never wrote, but rather for the oh-so-often maligned comic books, which nobody ever respected years ago. And even more ironic, the name you now sign is Stan Lee, which you adopted legally because you were embarrassed that Stanley M. Lieber was writing those lowly comics, which have since become the wellspring for respected motion pictures, TV series, video games, and all sorts of enormously popular globe-spanning entertainment. So bear this in mind, my impulsive 16-year-old self. Nothing ever stays the same. Tastes change, and the culture changes. The important thing is to stay on top of what is au courant and to be resilient enough to go with the flow and change with the tide. And if you're lucky enough to be one who contributes to the change in culture, never forget your roots or those who helped you make the grade. Excelsior. You, Stan